wish you a beautiful good morning here in wonderful Los Angeles. In the amazing backyard of my good friend Kristie, who graciously is hosting me at the moment. And today I want to invite you to do a core and hip class with us. It'll be a slightly stronger class. There'll be a few flow elements. And just try it out. None of the poses have to be perfect. Everything that we do in these classes is not to cram our body into the poses. It is to use the poses to become more present in our bodies. And with that, I'll invite you to take a deep inhale. Exhale with a sigh. Inhale. Last inhale. And then feel how with every inhale, you grow ever so slightly taller in your seat by pulling the crown of your head towards the sky. And with every exhale, let your sitting bones root deep into the ground. And that way we create more length along the spine. Become very present in your body. You're on your mat for the next hour. Nothing else matters. Only what's happening on your mat and what you can feel in your body. How present can you stay with your breath? With your next inhale, bring your arms overhead, reach your fingertips tall. And then with the exhale, fold forward, reach your hands on the ground as far away from you as you can. And once you are as far up front as you can, relax your neck. Keep breathing deep down here. And with every exhale, check where you can still get a little softer. Maybe if you do this in the early morning, you're going to feel it in your lower back, gently loosening up. Maybe you feel it in your hips. And then with your next inhale, walk your fingertips over to your right side, so that your upper body is over your thigh. Keep your hands somewhat close together, so hands are no more than shoulder width apart. And then check whether your left sitting bone has left the mat, and if so, then let it sink back down. Your next inhale, walk your hands over to the other side. Again, your hands stay somewhat close together and make sure that your right sitting bone this time does not leave the mat. If it does, gently encourage it to sink back down. With your next inhale, gently walk your hands back to center and then back towards your feet. press your hands into the ground right behind you, very close to your spine. Depending on how long your arms are in comparison to your upper body, that means put the palms down or put the fingers down. For me, it's just the fingers. I got short arms. And then with an inhale, reach your heart up and gently lift your gaze if that's okay for your neck. If you're at your edge, you stay right here. If you'd like to take it a little further for another three breaths, you can, in addition, lift your hips up and forward to go deeper into the pose. Your third exhale, slowly come back down. And then bring your hands out in front of you and we'll come into tabletop. So your hands are right underneath your shoulders and your knees are right underneath your hips.
Mom, the black thing that we found, it was a newt. My grandpa told me it was a newt.
You see, we're recording a video.
Okay.
All right. With your inhale, let your belly sink down, reach your heart forward. And with the exhale, round your spine, tuck your chin, tuck your tailbone. Inhale, let your belly sink down, reach your heart forward. Exhale, round your back. Inhale, belly sinks down, heart reaches forward. Exhale, round. Inhale, belly sinks down, reach your heart forward. Exhale, round. Two more. Inhale, reach your heart forward. Inhale, reach your heart forward. Exhale. With your next inhale, come to a neutral back position. Exhale here. Make sure you spread your fingers really wide and press all your knuckles into the mat. And then with your next inhale, reach your right arm forward. And with the exhale, press your left leg back, press the heel towards the back of the mat. How deep can you breathe here? Next inhale, reach that heel and fingertips a little further, and then with the exhale, bring the elbow and the knee together underneath you. Inhale, reach them out again. Exhale, pull them together. Inhale, reach out. Exhale, pull together. Inhale, reach out. Exhale, bring the hand and the leg back down onto the mat. With your next inhale, bring the left hand forward. With your exhale, reach the heel back. Naturally, if all of this reaching the arm forward is plenty and the leg gets too much, then...
I like your sweater. It's cool.
Thank you. If reaching that arm forward is already plenty on your back and that leg starts getting too heavy, you can always reduce it just reaching that arm forward. It'll definitely challenge your back muscles. One more inhale here. Exhale, pull the knee and the elbow together underneath you. Inhale, reach. Exhale, pull. Inhale, reach. Exhale, pull. Inhale, reach out a last time. Give it everything. Reach a little wider. And with the exhale, bring the hand and the knee back down on the mat. And then sit back onto your heels. Reach your arms out front, come into a child's pose. Your forehead can rest on the mat. Depending on how your back feels today, you can choose to keep your thighs close together, or you can take them apart. Take a couple of deep breaths here, resting your forehead on the mat. This pose is available to you at any point during your practice, whenever you need a little breather. So don't be afraid to come back here. Sometimes the toughest thing is deciding to take a break. With your next inhale, come back up onto your hands and your knees. And then with another inhale, tuck your tippy toes, lift your hips up and back, and come into downward dog. Here you want to bend one knee at a time. You gently feel out where your body is today. And eventually find some stillness with both legs going as straight as is available to you today. If your lower back is really tight, then you can bend those knees quite a bit. If your hamstrings are super tight, just take your feet a little wider. So you just feel out what's the best for you today. And then make sure that all fingers are pressing into the mat. And then try to soften between your shoulder blades and keep your neck nice and long. You can gently shake it yes and shake it no to check whether that's the case. With your next inhale, bend your knees a lot, look forward in between your hands, and with the exhale, walk it forward in between your hands. With an inhale, reach your heart forward, come halfway up. Exhale, fold back down. Inhale, come all the way up to standing, arms reach tall. Exhale, lower your hands to your heart. Inhale, reach your arms up. Exhale, fold forward. Inhale, come halfway up. Exhale, hands onto the mat, and then step the left leg back and come into a low lunge. So place your knee on the mat, untuck the back toes. Come up onto your fingertips here and then reach your heart forward. If your hands have a hard time touching the ground here, you can always take two blocks to modify this. So we have a couple of blocks available here today. That said, you could also use some thick books, a roll of toilet paper, or whatever you find handy, a rolled up blanket. All of those will do as blocks. Take one more deep inhale here. Your next inhale, tuck the back toes, lift the knee off the mat. Exhale, step the right leg back, plank pose. Inhale here. exhale, lower your knees and then your chest and then your chin. This is called eight-limbed pose. I sometimes call it booty sticks up awkwardly pose, but it's really beautiful to open up your middle back. So pull your elbows back towards your hips and enjoy that feeling of opening. Your next inhale, press into your hands, scoot forward onto your belly, elbows still pull back towards your hips, and come into a baby cobra. You don't have much weight here in your hands. This is to activate your upper back muscles. Exhale, come back down. Inhale, press into your hands and knees, come into tabletop, and then tuck your toes. Exhale, come up and back into downward facing dog. Take two deep breaths here. With your next inhale, lift the left leg off the mat. With the exhale, pull the knee to your chest and then step it forward into a low lunge. Let the right leg sink back onto the mat, untuck the back toes, come onto your fingertips or your blocks. Reach your heart forward a lot. Oh, by the way, I always say fingertips here. The truth is, I need to get on my fingertips because I have short arms compared to my upper body. Maybe you plant your palms and you're as straight as I am. So whatever works for your body, everybody's geometry is slightly different. Next inhale, press into the hands, tuck the back toes, lift the knee off the mat and step it back into plank pose. Inhale here, exhale, lower knees, chest and chin. Inhale, scoot your heart forward, baby cobra. Exhale, come back down. Inhale, press into tabletop, hands and knees. Exhale, tuck your toes, lift your hips up and back into downward facing dog. Inhale, lift the right leg high and then stay here. Take a deep breath, try to keep your hips square for a moment. That means your right hip is not yet going higher than the left one. And feel how that intensifies the stretch on your left calf. And then open that right leg up towards the sky so that the toes are pointing to the side and your hip is pointing up. Bend that upper leg so your heel comes closer to the bottom. And if your neck is okay with it, you can look underneath that armpit and just enjoy that little hip opener. And with your next inhale, straighten that leg again so that the toes are pointing down towards the mat. And then with the exhale, pull the knee into your chest. Hold it here. Inhale, press the leg back up. Exhale, pull the knee into your chest. Inhale, press the leg back up. Exhale, pull the knee into your chest. And this time, we're going to step that foot out to the other side, to the left side, on the outside of that right foot. This is called star pose, and we'll lift that arm. Make sure you use all five fingers on the right side to keep your wrist happy. With your next inhale, bring that left hand back onto the mat. Pull the knee into your chest and step it through. Okay, from here, we're going to raise our arms up into high lunge. this pose is super wobbly, you can always heel toe the front of the foot, the front foot outward. That way you're more on train tracks as opposed to on a tight rope. Last inhale here. Exhale, bring your hands back down onto the mat. Step the right leg back, plank pose. Inhale here. Exhale, lower knees, chest, and chin. Inhale, scoot your heart forward. Baby cobra, maybe we'll come up a little higher than previously. Exhale, come back down. Inhale, press into hands and knees, tabletop. Exhale, tuck your toes. Downward facing dog. Two breaths here. With your next inhale, lift the left leg up. Toes are still pointing down towards the ground. Your left hip is still pointing down. Feel the intensity on the stretch in the right leg, and then gently open up that left hip so that the toes are pointing to the side, hip is facing up, and then pull the heel towards your bottoms. If your neck feels okay with that, you can look underneath that left armpit. Your next inhale, bring that leg back to straight, toes are pointing down, and with the exhale, pull the knee into your chest. Inhale, press back up into three-legged dog. Exhale, knee into chest. Inhale, press up a last time. Exhale, knee into chest, and then this time we're going to set it over to the right. So outside of your left foot, setting to the right, and reach that arm up. Last inhale here, beautiful work. I know this pose is pretty tough on your obliques down here. Can you feel them? I can sure feel mine. Exhale, bring the hand back down onto the mat. Bring the knee into the chest, step it forward. Inhale, your arms up. Your heart up. How deep can you breathe here? Make sure your lower abs stay engaged to protect your lower back. Last inhale here. Exhale, bring the hands back down onto the mat. Step it back, plank pose. From here on, you have the option every time we go down here, you can either continue to do knees, chest, chin, or you can come down into a lower plank. Inhale, scoot your heart forward, and now listen to your back. If your back is warmed up, you can come up higher. If your back is not very happy, you stay down here, okay? So listen to your back. Exhale, come back down. Inhale, press into your hands and your knees. Exhale, tuck your toes, lift your hips up and back, downward facing dog. Take two breaths here and soften that spot in between your shoulder blades. With your next inhale, bring the right leg off the mat. Exhale, pull the right knee to the right elbow. Inhale, bring it back. Exhale, right knee, left elbow. Inhale, bring it back. Exhale, right knee, right elbow. Inhale, bring it back up. Exhale, knee to center chest, and then step it through. Let your left heel come down onto the ground this time, toes open up to the side, and we'll cartwheel up left arm, right arm into Warrior Two. Make sure you can see a big toe on the inside of that knee. If not, you can put a little more weight onto the pinky toe until you see it. That keeps your inner knee protected. Fingertips reach out over the front and the back leg. Your gaze goes over the front arm. With your next inhale, flip your front palm. With the exhale, raise the front hand, let the back hand sink onto the back leg. Make sure you feel the stretch in your side as opposed to doing a back bend. If you feel like you're actually back bending here, come out of the pose and just try again. Last inhale here. Exhale, come back out of the pose. Bring the right hand to the inside of the thigh. You can either place the elbow on the thigh, the hand on a block, or if you want to go deeper, fingertips on the inside of the leg and reach the left arm up. And then let your right butt cheek grow really heavy here. With your next exhale, let the left hand come down onto the mat. Put the block aside if you had one. And step the right leg back, plank pose. Inhale here. Exhale, lower down. Either way. Inhale, come into cobra. Exhale, back down. Inhale, press your hands and your knees into the mat. Exhale, tuck your toes, lift your hips up and back, downward facing dog. Two breaths here. With your next inhale, lift that left leg off the mat. Exhale, left knee goes to left elbow. I know this is challenging for the core, that's why it's a core class. Inhale, back up. Exhale, left knee to right elbow. That's exactly what you came for, and I love you for doing the work. Inhale, leg back up. Exhale, left knee to left elbow. Right on, you hang in there. Inhale, back up. That was the last one. Good work. Exhale, knee to center chest. And at the bottom of the exhale, step it through. Let your right heel come down onto the mat. Toes open up to the side. Right arm leads, and we'll cartwheel up into Warrior Two. So reach your fingertips to the front and to the back. Welcome to the scene, the German Shepherd, Deuce. In addition to all the chirping birds, I hope you can actually hear me over this. So check in with your front big toe, whether you can see that. If not, more weight on the pinky toe. And then hang deep here. Maybe you can go a little deeper. With your next inhale, flip your front palm. With the exhale, let the back hand sink onto the back leg. Reach the front arm up. Come into a side stretch. Check whether you've started to straighten your front leg. If so, go back to bending that knee. Last inhale here. Exhale, come back up. And then either bring your elbow on the thigh, hand on a block, or fingertips to the inside. Reach the right arm up. Left butt cheek becomes really heavy. Exhale, bring your hands back down to the ground, outside and both sides of the foot, and then step the left leg back, plank pose. We will go through the flow. Inhale here, exhale, lower down. Inhale, come forward, cobra. Exhale, come down. Inhale, into hands and knees. Exhale, tuck your toes. Lift your hips up and back. Downward facing dog. Two breaths here. With your next inhale, bring the right leg up. We're approaching the peak pose of this. It's the last really strenuous one. After that, we're gonna go softer. With your exhale, right knee to right elbow. Bring it up once more, inhale. I'm gonna go into the pose with the second one, Kulinyasana. So we're gonna try and bend our elbows and bring that knee on top of the elbow. And your left elbow goes underneath your rib cage. And then you see if you can float up that back leg just a tiny bit and press it back up. And then come down into a seat here for a moment. Sit back. If you know what you're doing, and Kundalini is every day for you, you can just take a brief pause in a child's pose. And just let me show you what you really want to pay attention to. So you want to have your hands shoulder width apart, and as you come forward with that knee, you bend your elbows to 90 degrees and you bring your thigh onto that elbow. If that back leg comes off the mat or not, honestly, not so important right now, but your core is going to be working really hard. And then you come back. So come slowly out of your child's pose. Let's go back up into downward facing dog and give it one more try on this side, and then we'll give it two tries on the other side. You can do this. Yes, you can. Inhale, downward facing dog. Next inhale, lift your right leg. Exhale, pull the knee to the side, bend your elbows, and bring that thigh up onto the upper arm. Float or not, your call. Just reach your heart forward enough. Inhale, press back up. Exhale, come forward into plank. Come down any way you like, or take a break in child's pose. Your call. Inhale, cobra. Exhale, back down. Inhale, press up. Exhale, tuck your toes, downward facing dog. With your next inhale, bring the left leg up. Exhale, left knee goes to left elbow. Inhale, back up. Exhale, left knee to left elbow. And then bend those elbows. See if you can get that thigh up onto the elbow.
Oh, crap.
Hold it here. Inhale, back up. Take a brief pause in a child's pose or just right here in downward dog. And we'll go for a second round. Inhale, your left leg up. Exhale, pull the knee onto the elbow. Bend the elbows, reach your heart forward. As you can see, I struggle a lot more with the left side, and that's okay. Inhale, back up. Exhale, come forward into plank. The side that we struggle with more, in acro yoga we like to call that the fun side. And it's okay, the sides are different, and they may feel different every day. Exhale, come down. Inhale, come forward. Exhale, down. Inhale, tabletop. Exhale, child's pose, you've earned it. You stay here for three more breaths while I quickly check my notes. with your next inhale, come back up into tabletop. Tuck your toes, lift your hips up and back, downward facing dog. Inhale, bend your knees a lot, look forward in between your hands. Exhale, walk it forward. Inhale, bring the palms of your hands against the soles of your feet if that is in reach. If that seems to be hard in reach, bend your knees a lot. If that is still hard, get those knees out to the side. And if that doesn't work, just bend your knees a lot and press the tops of your hands into the mat. So the point of this pose is I want you to stretch out the top of your wrists because those have just been working hard. So whether it is right here or whether you get them under the feet, either one does the same thing. Stay here for two more breaths. Really good work. You've gotten through the hardest part. I applaud you. I seriously do. This is hard work. With your next inhale, slowly roll up to standing. Roll your shoulders back. Come into a wide-legged stance. This is, I would say, about three times your shoulder width, but again, check in with your body, which geometry is good for you here. Press your hands into your lower back, fingertips are pointing down, reach your heart forward with an inhale. Exhale, fold forward at the hip. Again, you can use a block or whatever prop you have instead of a block and press down into the block right here. You can use the flat side of the block or you can place your hands down if that's available to you. If this one is fairly easy for you, then you can still walk your hands further back until your fingertips are in line with your toes. You want to make sure that you have about as much weight in your tippy toes as you have in your heels. So check whether you're leaning back a lot and then have the courage to put more weight into the balls of your feet as well. Now if you want to get really adventurous, you can strive to go for a tripod headstand. If right here is where you're working today, that is perfect. If you're on a block, perfect. All that matters is that you stay focused on what you're doing in your body and that you breathe. Breathe deep. Hang right here. If you do wish to take it further, here's an option for tripod headstand. You would walk your fingers all the way back in line with your feet and then bring the top of your head down and then slowly raise out of your core. I'm not even sure I should demo that here because I want you to take this one slow, so I'm just going to show you the lead into it. So place the top of your head down and just feel what that feels like to put any weight on here. So for most of you, putting the top of your head down to the mat, that is a pretty cool limit to reach for now. And if you ever want to take it further, then you can still slowly start lifting from there, but never kick. Never do this with dynamic movement. Always just very slow and gentle. That was a somewhat failed attempt. I couldn't quite hold it there. I'm going to try one more time and then we're going to continue. With your next inhale, bring your hands back to your hips, and with the exhale, come back up. Good work. With that, we're gonna heel-toe the feet together until the heels are just about hip width and our toes are pointing outward, and we'll come down into Malasana. Malasana is also called yogi squat. And with every inhale, you reach your heart up, and with every exhale, you let your hips grow heavier. You may get not all the way down here, maybe because your ankles are not quite there yet, or because your hips or your knees don't allow you yet. So there's a couple of options of how you can be in between. You can always probably come down here. Maybe your heels are already coming off. And you can just use either your forearms or your elbows to keep those knees apart. And just slowly work here, that's perfect. If that's too much on your thighs, you can use a block and press down and take some of the weight out. So you know where your limit is today, whether you can come down here, or whether you're here and your heels lift off. What I want you to work on is to feel a stretch here on the inside and to feel a stretch in those hips. And I'm sure you've found that by now. Yes, good work. Two more breaths here. With your next inhale, take whatever prop you have aside and come to sit down on your bottoms. Do a little round of boat pose. So for that, you want to reach your hands forward, reach your heart up, and then float up your feet. You can start here. If you want more, you come into half boat. You keep your abs tight here. And with every exhale, you pull the navel towards your spine. With every inhale, you reach your heart up. With every exhale, navel towards your spine. And if you still want more than this, you can reach out your legs and come into full boat pose and have straight legs. Two more breaths here. Exhale, pull the knees into your chest. We'll do one more of these. Good core workout, I know. Last one. Inhale, bring your legs up as far as is appropriate for you today. Exhale, bring the knees back into your chest. Good work. And then from here, we're going to sit on our left. We'll bring the right leg back and we'll come into pigeon pose. So there's a couple of options here. First of all, if you're not very used to pigeon or your hips are fairly tight, and you know what? I've been doing this for 20 years. I still have fairly tight hips. My pigeon is not very deep, but I'll show you because it's a super important pose to work on for gently opening your hips. So you bring your shin close to you, and then you pull your toes back towards that knee. That'll keep your knee protected. And then you straighten out your shoulders so that your shoulders and your hips are all facing the front of the mat. Now, if you feel that your left hip has come off the mat, first of all, that's okay. And second, you may want to put a prop underneath it. So for right now, I just have a block here. If you have a folded blanket, that's actually a little more comfortable. So put something in between so that then you can start softening, but you're still supported under that left hip. Take a couple of deep breaths here. And if you like, you can either come onto your forearms or you can even lay down completely. Now, while you find your version of it, if all of this is super easy and you just flop down, What you want to work on is bring that shin further out front, like this. That will intensify the stretch. Right now you can see that my left hip is off the mat, so I'm not there. It depends on how flexible your hips are. So I'm gonna scoot my leg further back. Like this is the range of motion that I have here today. With your next inhale, slowly come back out of the pose. Bring your hands onto the mat, tuck the back toes, and then lift that knee off the mat, reach it up to the sky, maybe open it up to the other side for a moment, reach the leg up again, and bring it down, and then we'll switch sides. Reach the leg up, and pull that right knee forward into your chest, and then bring that shin forward for as wide and as far as is good for you today. Remember to pull the toes back towards that front knee to keep your knee happy. And you'll see that also on my right side, my hip is off the ground. So I'm going to scoot that block under there to have a bit of support to then be able to soften into the pose with every breath. And again, you find your right level here, you find how far forward or how far back you have to scoot that leg. You want that heel somewhere close to your left hip if you don't feel that flexible here yet, and you can scoot that heel further towards the wrist, or that entire foot further towards the wrist if this does feel very easy. And then when you found the pose, you can come down on your forearms if that feels good, or even lay down completely. Give it three more deep breaths where you are. With your next inhale, press back into your hands, come back out of the pose. Tuck the back toes, lift the knee off the mat, and reach the right leg up to the ceiling. If you like, you can open your hips here for a moment. Bring that heel to the back. Inhale, straighten it again. Exhale, bring it forward, walk forward. Come into a forward fold. And then let your hips come down. I'm going to sit down here. Nice work. So bring the soles of your feet together here. Maybe nice and close. You can hold on to your ankles to make sure that this is as tight as you can go. And then find a block or something else that you can lay on as we lay back into a reclined butterfly. You want to have this block right at the bottom edges, corners of your shoulder blades. That's where it feels best. Actually, to me it feels best if I take it sideways in exactly that pose. If you put it too low, you'll notice it's uncomfortable on your back. If it's too high, it's going to bother your neck. If it's in the perfect spot, probably right at the edge underneath the shoulder blade, then it's going to feel like a nice opener across your heart space.
Hey, get down. Oh, you're freaking out about it. Get down. That's what you're freaking out about.
three more deep breaths right here. Again, if you don't have a block, use a rolled up blanket, use a roll of toilet paper, any of those work. It's going to be very flat toilet paper after that, yes. The book may last better, or the blanket. Last inhale here. And with the exhale, gently roll to the side and take that support out. You can stay right here on the side, and you can use your right hand to grab that left knee and pull it close to your chest, and then see if you can grab a hold of the right foot with your left hand. We're going to come into a pose called cat's tail. So you're going to try and gently pull this leg back, the right leg, and then lay your shoulders back down on the mat. If there is no way this right leg is going anywhere, then a good alternative pose for you is to just pull both knees up into your chest and stay right here in a side twist. And your gaze can go over that left arm towards the back. Give it three more breaths here, whichever version of the pose you're in. Let me also tell you whether you have both knees together and are in a twist, or whether you have one leg in each hand, it doesn't really matter. What matters is that you keep breathing deep. It matters that you keep working here and staying present in your body. With your next inhale, gently let go of that right leg if you are holding it, and then roll onto your back, pull the knees into your chest, and gently make circles in one direction, and then in the other one. And then we'll do that same pose on the other side. So here are your options. You can bring both knees over, and just come into the twist here, and this is a perfectly good pose that in many of the classes I will do and not even offer cat's tail, because I think it's such a nice opening right here along the back and along the hip, especially this area right here. That's where it feels good to me. Good and challenging. And if you would like to take it a little deeper, then you can take that left leg, reach it back, see if you can grab a hold of that foot, and gently hold it right here in place. It's going to intensify the stretch here because it's going to make your twist deeper. So you pick your level of twisting. With three more deep breaths here. And then gently let that leg go. roll onto your back, pull the knees into your chest. A couple of little circles one way and then the other way. Reach the soles of your feet up towards the sky. Grab them from the outside or the inside, whichever is easier available for you according to the geometry of your body. If it's hard to get them up here, hold your ankles somewhere here. You're going to get the same stretch out of it. It's just as you progress over time, you will make your way here eventually. And gently pull them down so the knees come closer to the earth and so that your tailbone comes closer to the mat. And the most important part about happy baby pose is you pull the corners of your mouth back towards your ears. And then, if you feel like you want to get some wiggles out, you can also gently roll from left to right. It'll give you a really nice lower back massage. And when you're done wiggling and find stillness, give it two more breaths here. With your next inhale, gently come back out of the pose. And lay down flat, come into Shavasana, corpse pose, your final resting pose. Lay your shoulder blades flat against the mat so that your shoulders can relax. Let your palms face the sky, that helps the heart space to open. And if it's uncomfortable for you to lay on your back like this, you always have the option to just roll around and lay on your belly instead and rest one cheek on your folded hands. You get comfortable. The reason why we do this pose is to integrate the practice. To relax for a moment so that everything that we've just done can integrate into muscle memory, into reflex memory, and to just ease back into a fully relaxed state. So relax your forehead. Relax your jaw. Relax the tongue off the roof of your mouth. Let your eyes roll back into your head. Soften anything that still has tension. Sink into the back of your body and let your breath wash over you. With your next inhale, slowly come back into your body. Start breathing a little deeper. Start moving your hands and your feet, maybe on a circle, wrists and ankles. With another inhale, reach your arms overhead. Exhale, pull the knees into your chest. Curl up into a tiny ball, hug those knees, and say thank you to yourself for showing up for your practice. And then roll over onto your right side. feel how you're supported here. You're nurtured by the earth. And you are loved exactly as you are. With your next inhale, slowly press back up into a seated position. And come into a cross-legged seat. Or whatever else is comfortable right now. Just so your spine is nice and tall. And I invite you to feel inward for a moment. What has shifted since the beginning of your practice today? Maybe you feel a little more loose, energized and tired at the same time in your physical body. Maybe you notice a little more space in between your thoughts. Maybe some of your emotions have mellowed out a little. And maybe you feel a little more connected to that spark deep inside of you that's still here when we forget about all our labels. That beautiful, beautiful divine soul. Bring your arms up with the last inhale. Exhale, lower your hands to your heart. I thank you for letting me guide you through this class today. I hope to see you soon. I'd love to hear from you. Namaste. So a couple of credits at the end of this little class. Thank you so much for joining me. Credits go to my friend Kristie, a special guest who was doing the class with me right here. Her son Smith, racing around in between neighbor Brian upstairs and his dog Deuce. All the little birds that have made a pretty exciting background music. I hope you could still hear the instructions over all of this. And like I said, I'd love to hear from you. Let me know what you thought. Let me know what would be helpful for you to get an addition. And I'm here for you, and I'm happy to be of service. Thank you.